Very, very good morning, guys. Welcome to All Aboard Speed Reading Practice 2.0 session. So, very good morning. Quickly join in, Santosh. How are you? Quickly share the session also so that we can begin with today's editorial. Guys, I hope your exam went well for 20th and 21st, all slots, SBI PO pre-exam. So, we did practice a lot. Now, there is the third day, which is 27th, when the exam will happen. So, I hope all of the editorial vocabulary we revised, whatever we read in classes, we practiced, was helpful in the exam, particularly English section. Hope you have done well, right? Okay. Very, very good morning, guys. Accuracy will play a role, and let's see how many of you will clear this. But now, going forward, you already have your IBPS PO admit card out, for which we will start the class today, 5 p.m., right? So, IBPS PO, and now, should you prepare for mains? That's the question. So, if your attempts have been good enough with terms, like in relation with, of course, accurate attempts with accuracy, then you should start preparing for mains also simultaneously. So, IBPS PO pre is next, and simultaneously you have to prepare for mains also. You understand that, right? Okay. Now, before I begin, guys, extremely important thing which I need to share with all of you is about the courses. So, today also we are starting with a new course. Okay, which is a crash course for IBPS. Okay, I'll move to the PPT here. So, if you haven't enrolled, now see, most of you have given your prelims exam, SBI PO prelims exam, right? What is the next step? You prepare for mains. Okay, so you prepare for mains. You definitely need preparation for mains descriptive also. So, please, guys, if you haven't enrolled, do that at the earliest using my code Harshita. You will get maximum discount also. I will be evaluating your essays personally. It is a complete descriptive course. Validity is 6 months. So don't worry whether, you are not sure whether I'll clear or no. Any of these exams, guys, it is useful for all of these. NIACL, SBI, IBPS, all the mains exam. Okay. 23 in English. Manoj, not bad. Good attempts in English. But yeah, your accuracy should be 100%. Okay. Acha, Lovepreet, you have the papers on the same day. For you, I would like to see. Okay. What I have done is, guys, those who have paper on the same day, IBPS PO and also NIACL mains. There were more candidates. Some of the candidates I have mentioned right to their grievance portal and see what might happen. But what I will suggest is, guys, you will have to ultimately decide. So if you don't get a response or if they don't change the dates, you will have to decide which one to write. Okay. Now I know vacancies are more in IBPS PO, but you have cleared pre, which is a big thing in NIACL, right? Okay. Strategy video, MSCT, I'll soon give it to you, the strategy, complete strategy. Okay. Guys, see, clerk batch 2 is there, but like I said, I really want you to understand. Here, IBPS PO selection batch is there already. On the website, you will see there are more and more courses coming up. So, the newest ones that are there, upcoming courses, like I said, which starts today only, it is your LPS sessions for IBPS SO. So, video, lectures, this is a video course, plus live practice sessions will be there. Okay. Then we have, of course, IBPS, which starts today. IBPS clerk crash course, which is your batch 2. Okay. This also starts today, 22nd November. Okay. This also starts today, 22nd November. So, all the new courses you check. Now, best is you buy Edge subscription. So, if you want access, you are writing so many exams, multiple exams. So, what is the profit? How will it be advantageous to you? Buy Edge subscription so that you can access multiple courses. Simple as that. Okay. You are going to access multiple courses because you are writing multiple exams. Okay. So, please buy Edge subscription. Again, using my code, you will get discount. Okay. Something, guys, which will be helpful for you. That is what I am telling you. Okay, instead of buying individual courses, you go for Edge subscription, All Aboard Edge subscription. And that way, what you will get is access to many courses, multiple courses, right? And using my name, you can get maximum discount also. Now let's begin. Today's topic is from The Hindu newspaper. Quickly, guys. Also, I would request all of you watching this, please share the session. See, one important thing, you shouldn't stop reading. This is extremely important. If you're writing any of these exams, you will see in English section, this is ultimately going to help you. It will increase your confidence level in the exam, in RCs and in other parts also. Achha, Swati just now woke up. Swati, so each day, 9 a.m. we have this editorial. Chalo. Guys, first all of you will read and then I will discuss the meaning of this particular article with you, paragraph with you. Quickly, start reading all of you. So, this is the meat of the matter. When we use it as an idiom, we say the most important matter. Okay, yeah. About is not after compromise, Swati. So, about means approx. For this percentage, we are using approx. About is approximately 15%, approx. Okay. So, when we show how much about, if we write, it means here for percentage, approx means approx. Okay. Not exact figure, but approximately this much. Okay. Happy that the title is not non-vegetarian. So, something about that only is mentioned. So, ideological means, guys, ideological is based on or relating to a particular set of ideas, okay? Based on a particular set of opinions, set of ideas. Achha, meat of the matter, mutton laga tha. Okay, meat of the matter is an idiom which means the basic part, element. Now, predominant, you all know something which is most noticeable, most powerful, most important. Okay, right. What does this say? Since the population of Gujarat comprises about 15% STs, 10% Muslims, 7.5% SCs, 50% other backward classes and migrants, most of whom, guys, why whom is used here? Because obviously we are referring to the, of course, all of these classes, the object. They don't have ideological aversions to meat. Means they are not against or they don't hate or dislike meat. Unlike, we are showing dissimilarity, unlike the Jains and Vaishnavs, we can safely say that a predominant share of the population is meat eating. So when we talk about Gujarat particularly, here we are talking about the example of Gujarat is given. So in Gujarat, the most important or the maximum number of people or majority of the population is meat eating population. Okay? Clear everybody? Yes? Now, what is the problem then? See here, next para. We'll get some idea. So it's about food, how read the next para. Okay, Ananti, in the previous one, for all the, of course, categories we had used whom, migrants, most of whom, who don't have, and migrants, most of whom, right? So after blank, before that migrants was mentioned. You are correct, Anandi. Achha, hawkers and vendors, you know, people who sell goods informally, right, in public places. DK, very good morning. Guys, just one request to all of you. For these sessions, please tell your friends also, because I want more participation in 9 a.m. classes. Okay. So to definitely join for editorial each day 9 a.m. Okay. Now, teetotalers are people who do not consume alcohol. Okay, they don't have alcohol, they don't drink alcohol. So, teetotalers we say. Okay. Now, recently the BJP ruled civic bodies in Vadodara, Rajkot, Bhavnagar, Junagadh. They launched a drive. There was actually a big effort by these civic bodies of these particular places against the sellers and vendors, okay, who were running non-vegetarian food joints across streets and footpaths underground. Okay, what was the reason given? That it hurts religious sentiments. Okay, also after that, hundreds of food carts or stalls that were spread across selling non-vegetarian food were shut by the authorities. Okay. Now, if you say that Gujarat is a vegetarian state, it is similar to saying that people of state are non-alcoholic. They don't consume alcohol, okay, because alcohol is prohibited there, okay. But everybody knows about Gujarat that liquor, alcohol is freely available, okay. It is an open secret. Open secret means people have knowledge about it, people know it. Everybody knows it, that it is available. Though they say it is not allowed there, definitely it's an open secret about Gujarat, which everybody knows. It's available there, you can easily get it, okay. It is a fact known to many people. It's an open secret means it's a fact which is known to many people. Many are familiar with that fact, okay. Yeah, so people regularly consume non-vegetarian food, but increasingly not in the open. Why? Because they fear that they will be, of course, strongly stopped, okay, questioned, and in a formal way, the body, civic bodies or other authorities will question them, right? Okay, rats research in Palmyra Island RC was asked yesterday. Okay, Tarun, I hope you were able to do. Guys, in SBI PO, what I have heard from the feedback that I have got is people were able to do. They were not very, very tough RCs. They were doable reading comprehension questions. You were able to understand and answer, right? 8 marks, 10 marks in different slots. Minimum 8 marks RC was there. Like I told you, it will be there. And it was a doable question, right? Yeah. So guys, for all alcohol, door delivery is available. Now in Gujarat also, when we say that non-vegetarian, when they are banning non-vegetarian food, that sellers or hawkers can't sell it, saying that it will hurt the sentiments, religious sentiments of the people, that is not fair, because even Gujarat, we can't say Gujarat is a vegetarian state. As our author has mentioned, that majority of the population is meat-eating population there. Okay, when you talk about migrants or the backward classes, all of those are meat-eating population. And if you say that it is a vegetarian state, you are saying basically even people don't consume alcohol, they are teetotalers. But that is not true, because everybody knows that alcohol flows everywhere. Okay, it is available. yeah, and people consume. So akin means similar to. Akin, A-K-I-N. Guys, when we use this word, we show similarity. Akin to means something similar to. Okay? Tanishq is asking, akin, is it related to families also, relatives also, kin? For that, we have another word which is K-I-N. Kit and kin. Kin we say. For family members, we use only kin. K-I-N. Okay? Tanishq? Yeah. Next. Next para is about idea of vegetarianism. Quickly read this. Quickly read this para. What does it say, guys? Yeah, when we say exclusive vegetarian restaurant, exclusive is special, okay, separate, exclusive, okay, only to be used by the vegetarians, okay, special, and not welcoming people who eat non-vegetarian. Dominant is major, you all understand that, okay? The dominant culture, the main, dominant here is main Mahajan culture, okay? Austerity, if you remember, we have learned this word so many times, we have seen it in articles also, where there is strictness, discipline of living, where there is non-indulgence in luxury, okay? Jab hum Hindi mein bolte hain, sahi hum, kathorta basically, strict policies that we follow, strictness in living also. Okay, right. Elites means a special class, or we can say a more powerful, a different social group. We refer to as elites, basically a select group which are considered superior than the others, right? A select group of people. So how will they be superior in terms of, you can say, social status, or ability or qualities? They are different, the elites, okay? So they are different, we say elites, okay? Now see, what does this para say? Gujarat socio-culture space, okay, the area which is social plus when we talk about cultural factors, majority is dominated by Jains and Vaishnavs. Now, in order to provide services to these elites, this select group, Pizza Hut opened its first exclusive vegetarian restaurant in Ahmedabad. Celebrity chef Sanjeev Kapoor, we have all heard about this chef, I hope. Okay, he also opened his first ever all vegetarian restaurant in Ahmedabad. Okay, so the main Mahajan culture is marked by beliefs in non-violence, teetotalism. You all understand now? Teetotalism means not consuming alcohol. Okay. And austerity, strict living, okay? So, social values emphasized by Mahatma Gandhi, they work on this principle. Now, while vegetarianism is seen as central to this culture, see, cultures are different and food plays a major part. You all understand that food also determines the culture. Food is a major part of any culture if you talk about. So, vegetarianism, if you talk about, it is central, it is main to this particular culture. So, the practice vegetarianism is a noun word meaning not having meat or fish, right? Because of religious reasons particularly, okay, or health reasons, so you adopt vegetarianism, okay, right? So, that is as central to this culture. And meat eating in this particular part has become, it is stigmatized, means people are disapproving it, okay? And if you eat meat, probably they will make you feel unimportant or less deserving, or they'll show their disapproval straightforward. But the fact is that large section of the society are meat eaters, even after that, okay? So, the Swadhyay Parivar or Swaminarayan movements, they have strengthened vegetarianism, this particular practice in Gujarat, okay? So, this is what is mentioned. If you talk about the cultural factors, social factors, definitely in Gujarat, they are dominated by the Vaishnavs and the Jains, right? And to provide service to these elite or select or special group, there are restaurants being opened which are exclusively vegetarian restaurants. And this is how this particular culture has come in place. It's the dominant, it's the main margin culture which is followed. And it talks about beliefs in non-violence, okay? Of course, the Gandhi principles, right? Teetotalism and austerity, the Gandhi principles, right? Right? So, vegetarian culture is there. That is why this is happening. That is why meat eaters are prohibited by the civic bodies. They are stopped, okay? Right. Next one. Quickly read the next para, all of you. So, how the civic bodies and why they are against it, okay? Norms are your normal usual standards. Now, you see this, guys, all of these ministers who are there in the civic bodies also, how they are forcing a ban, okay? Done? Now, see, who is selling roadside food stalls? If you see who is selling meat, they are by the minorities, lower class, lower caste Hindus or by migrants, okay? They don't have any say. They can't put their point in the political affairs of the Gujarat. See, BJP has been in power in the state for more than 2 decades. We all know that. Okay, they control all the urban civic bodies of the main cities. Okay, and who are in the top position in that particular group? The Baniyas, Patels and Brahmins, right? So, they have their own social and cultural beliefs. And that only decides the social norms, the standards. That is why it is not surprising. It is not a surprising thing. They are the ones who are actually protesting against non-vegetarian food carts, right? Whether you talk about Minister of Revenue and Law, whether you talk about Justice Rajendra Trivedi, whether you talk about municipal corporation, town planning committee chairman, all of these people who are in high profile, you can say, designations, who are working. And therefore, yeah, the deprived class, those who are not exactly matching the level of the ones who have got enough opportunities, deprived class, right? So basically, when we talk about people who are actually protesting are these people, and the backward class, the deprived class, they do not have a say because they are not even included in the, they don't have the power in the state, right? They, the majority of the, you can say, people who are there in the government or in power in the state are the Baniyas, Patels and Brahmins, who are already, again, according to their religion, against the non-vegetarian food, okay, or non-vegetarianism. Now, deprived means something which people who are deprived, they don't have enough in life. They have not got enough opportunity. They don't have enough food or money. They are backward. They are deprived. Okay? Right? Clear, everybody? So, here, if you talk about BJP and in the main cities, the urban civic bodies, they comprise of people from the caste, from predominant 3-4 caste, which are against non-vegetarian food. Okay? Right. Non-vegetarian is an Indian English word. Yeah, non-vegetarianism or vegetarianism, definitely English word. Baniyas are another caste. Okay, usually when we refer to trader, people who are mostly traders, okay, their name is derived from that, traders and merchants, okay, the Baniyas, right? Coercive, when we say, I think coercive methods were used, right? Coercive means when you use force, you use threat, okay? So that people listen to you, you use your force, you use your threat, okay? Obstructing is blocking, preventing somebody, blocking traffic, very clearly. Here it is blocking traffic. Beliefs, okay. Swati, which line can you just mention? Then I will tell you, I will definitely clear your doubts, Swati. Just tell me which line you are saying beliefs is incorrectly used here. Cultural beliefs, social and cultural beliefs, it's a plural word, okay. Plural noun, so definitely correct. So we need a noun word here, Swati. So beliefs, this is the spelling we use, noun word. Okay, right. Contestation means the action of actually arguing, going against something basically, arguing. Assert, when you say something confidently. Now, see, fear of censure. People are scared. So, reacting to the outcry, the protest that followed the ban, what did the Gujarat CM say? BJP chief say that no action would be taken against vendors selling food. He also said that all the mayors will not take use of, will not make any use of force or threat against these people who are selling non-vegetarian food. CM stressed that the state was not bothered about what people ate. The state did not care. Okay. Did not bother, did not care about what people ate. Okay. Action will be taken only against people who are selling unhygienic. Okay. Not clean, not hygienic, not sanitized food. Okay. Right. Only against those And if the vendors, the stalls are blocking traffic, then there will be action. But people are still scared. There is fear. Okay, if they have done this earlier, the civic bodies have banned non-veg selling of non-veg food. Obviously, people will be scared. So, because these kind of bans, they actually stigmatize the marginalized communities. That is the problem. Okay, so the communities which are not so, which are the backward communities of a particular state, they, because of this particular ban, they are stigmatized. Okay. They feel a sense of disapproval. They feel a sense of authorities going against them. Action will be taken against them. They have that fear. Okay. So basically, these bans are imposed forcefully. These bans are done. There is nobody who is there to argue. Okay. And that which shows that the dominant, the main community is there. They show their dominance and they threaten the people, their livelihoods and their peace. Or how their peace is threatened, obviously they are stopped to work. They are migrants. They are other backward classes, lower classes, which, of course, get their livelihood, their, of course, income from running these stalls. Now, they are banned. Obviously, that is disturbing their peace, their livelihood. Okay. Stigmatized, like we discussed earlier. Here, I have mentioned the meaning also. To make somebody feel unimportant. When you stigmatize means you show disapproval. Okay, you make somebody feel less important or make somebody feel that they are doing something very wrong, stigmatize. Okay, right. Now, what is the tone, guys? The meat of the matter. The meat of the matter, what does the writer says? Fear of censure. How, you know, they are banning and how people are still scared. Who runs these particular stalls, right? Or non-vegetarian food is banned. Okay. So, what is the tone? It is descriptive. Okay. Yeah. Writer has definitely described the issue in detail. Okay. Critical, were their points directly blaming somebody? Concerned tone? Yeah. I would say majority, if you read the full para, it is descriptive plus concerned. Descriptive plus concerned. Okay. I will not say critical because direct, nobody is blamed in the para. Writer is not blaming directly anybody. So, I'll say descriptive plus concerned tone. Right? Yeah. Descriptive. Correct. Right. One thing, guys, I want you to understand akin to. When is this connector used? What to show? Akin. Akin to meaning? Imacity, you are still facing issues while understanding the tone. Okay, I'll give you one suggestion. First, you go through basic list of tones. Okay, what does this connector show, guys? Similarity. Similar to. What does this connector show? Similarity. Okay, now you'll remember this connector shows similarity. Okay, Massity, particularly for you, if you are still not able to actually understand the tones correctly, one request is go through the basic tone words, all the important ones. Okay, positive, negative, neutral tones, just read the list. Okay, from that we select tone each time. Okay, now guys, very quickly, let's start reading. Achha, ideological, I've written twice, it's okay. Ideological meaning related to a set of ideas or opinions or particular beliefs. Okay, ideological, related to set of beliefs. Okay, yes. What is coercive? Something which is using threat, using force, okay? Use of threat or force. Okay? Posh, when we say posh locality, guys, posh means definitely belonging to a high social class, right? Posh society. We say this word, okay? And the correct pronunciation is posh, right? So, we say posh society, we say posh locality, okay? So, what does posh means? As an adjective, we use it, belonging to high social class, high or it also means expensive or belonging to high social class. Higher class, right? Elite. Yes, you can say elite, Priyanka. Teetotalers. Who are teetotalers? People who don't consume alcohol. People who do not consume alcohol. Teetotalers. What happened, RJ? Why the paper was not good? Outcry means protest, okay, by many. Aversion, when you are averse to something, guys, you dislike it, okay? There is hatred towards it, okay? Aversion to. Guys, remember preposition that we use with averse. Very important grammar lesson again. We always say to. Fixed preposition that we use with averse is to. You are averse to it means you dislike it. You don't indulge in it. Okay? Averse to dislike. Preposition with averse, you will usually see to. Okay? Predominant. Predominant means the main. See guys, all those SBI PO pre was not so good. If you say that also, you have one more big opportunity, which is IBPS PO. Still one more big opportunity. By the way, guys, what are your dates for the exam? 4th and 11th? You have the paper 4th, 11th December? Okay. So tell me 4th, 11th. I think there are only two dates for IBPS PO pre, right? 4th December, 11th December, Saturdays that are there. 4th and 11th. Any other date? I don't think there is any other date for IBPS PO. 4th, 4th, 4th. There are only two days, right? 4th, 11th. Majority ka 4th ko hai. Okay. 4th and 11th. Both are Saturdays. Sadhana, yours is first day, first shift then. 4th, 8 a.m. Okay? So, only two dates. Guys, any special video you want from my side for IBPS PO, you let me know. What I am doing is for IBPS PO evening 5 p.m. on Olibod only. I am doing 10 days 10 paper because again we don't have enough time. 10 days 10 paper set. Okay. Acha, your marriage is also on 28th of November and you have your exam also. How will you manage, RJ? How will you manage? You see, whatever best you can do, definitely. Right? Any special particular video or in question type you want in the classes, you let me know. That's not a problem. Okay? Okay. Sentence improvement, phrasal verb, Aditi bol rahi hai. Words exactly, Sadhana, same nahi aate. Jo SBI PO wale words hai, wo IBPS PO mein hai, not necessary. Not necessary, same exact nahi aata. Okay? Acha, first attempt, I will say, guys, you have 10 days. What should you focus on? Evening sessions for English and mocks. Please complete your mocks. One request. For IBPS PO, complete your mocks also. Okay? Okay? Most vocabulary you want, we can do that. Swati, even what I was wondering, if we can do full revision of 200, 300 words for IBPS PO. That, and words were not very difficult. In SBI PO, the feedback that you guys have given me after giving the paper, there were simple words only, satisfying, interchange, okay, synonym of cool from the passage. So it was not very tough words that I have heard that was asked in SBI PO pre. It was very, very normal vocabulary that was there. Okay. Chalo, guys, elite class means belonging to the higher group, higher social status. Special class, so they have, you know, in terms of whether you say power, class, money, wealthy, the elites, okay? Stigmatized, again I will say, to make feel less important, to make someone feel less important, okay? Basically, here what I had mentioned, stigmatized, show strong disapproval. When you stigmatize against a particular group or class, you show strong disapproval. Okay? Right. So this elite class is same. The elites belonging to the higher class, upper class. Okay. Manoj, who said I am elite?
I am the rich class, na?
Okay. Grammar plus vocab. Swati, I'll make the best 10 days I will help you prepare the best, but extra whatever you want I will probably share, right? The other two suggested articles, right? Here comes the elite class. Okay, yeah, Musk is actually the elite class, I would say. I'm jealous of this particular Musk class. You are the elite class. Okay, you are the elite. Say hi to everybody. Say hi to everyone. Hi. Okay. So, guys, the other two articles I want you to read from today's newspaper, 22nd November. Oh, very, very less time for your exam, by the way. The Hindu and Financial Express. Very important is repeal of farm laws. This is your important descriptive topic also. Now that the farm laws are repealed, it can become a very, very, very important descriptive topic. So, I will put this in star mark. Okay. So, this can be very important descriptive topic also. Definitely read this from today's newspaper. This is your reading. Okay. Thank you, Piyush, so much. Okay, Aditi, his name is Musk. Musk Mellon, not Elon Musk. Okay. Musk, only Musk. Okay. Okay, grammar and vocab based close test. I will put that in my 5 p.m. session. Don't worry, Tarun, definitely. Question of the day today is mentioned in the comments. The meaning of the phrase cater to. You all know my Telegram group, guys. Do join it for all the best, or you can say important content before your exam. It is Harshita Khurana, the grammar girl. Today we have a lot of sessions. By the way, in English, if I say, we have class at 11 and LPS at 12. Then we have 4 p.m., 5 p.m., 6 p.m. sessions, right? So many sessions today. Okay, right. And do subscribe, like, and share. Guys, again, I will request join the course, using my code Harshita. So whatever you are preparing, multiple exams are there. You can use Edge subscription. Using my code, you'll get discount. And then you can access multiple courses on Olibod platform. That will be useful for all of you. Okay. Indirect tha RC, Gargi in SBI. So IBPS also probably will give definitely few indirect questions. We will practice those also. Okay. Chalo. Take care, guys. See you in the evening. All aboard YouTube channel, 5 p.m. for practice questions. Please be there. IBPS PO practice. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much.